There you go. Oh, my goodness. That's a pretty wild-looking place. So, I say you want to go away? That's fine. Go on away. But don't go away a little. Go away a lot. Now, here's a filly that isn't terribly aggressive about going away, but she's disoriented in here. And it's a strange place to her. She's not comfortable with barging forward into an area that she's not familiar with. And that's sometimes a bit of a problem, and it certainly doesn't hurt to acclimatize your horse to a round pen for 3 or 4 days or even more if they are wild and unfamiliar. Now we know that we want her to go both ways because the flight animal is that sort that investigates every opportunity to flee in directions whatever available. And in a round pen, you essentially have a direction left and a direction right available to you. I use this light line so that if it should go out there and hit her, it can't cause her any pain, because pain would be exactly what we don't want to have happen. Leastwise, she simply couldn't come in and join up with me. Now we've done both directions, and we'll take the pressure off, and we'll start thinking equus. We'll watch for this conversation, and it's coming fast. This ear closest to me is locked on. She's already brought her head off that wall twice now, wanting to come in closer. My eyes on eyes, shoulders square, pushing away. There's licking and chewing. Very nice. Very nice. So, we've predicted the ear, we've predicted the head and the eye coming over, coming closer. We've nailed our prediction on the licking and chewing, and there's the bowing down. There's the bowing down. Very nice. Super good girl. That's so demonstrative right there. That's just as you see the Mustang do it. There's the licking and chewing again. Quite good. Very good conversation. Next round, I will go passive. Good licking and chewing. I will go passive the next round, take my left shoulder by, and then drop my eyes away from her eyes and reverse the whole procedure. There we go. I'll get myself on a 45 now and invite her in. Very nice. Super good girl. There is the moment of join up. You are a good girl. So I'll tell her how nice she is for coming in here. Invite her into my chest, standing right in front. Don't look her in the eye. I've already done that, and that means go away. Now I want her to be here with me, and she's finding value. And that's join up, and now I'll walk away and attempt to get follow-up. Wonderful. Wonderful. Good follow-up. I'll come around here now and try to make a left turn and have her come with me. Super good girl. On the offside as well, vulnerable areas. And I want to be able to pick up each of her feet with nothing on her head if possible, hoping that she'll stay with me, because when I saddle, I'd like her to stay with me because she wants to, not because she's being made to. Good girl. That's a good girl. Okay. Okay. Good girl. And that's the first saddle pad of her life. That I can assure you of. And this is the first saddle of her life. And there it is. That's the first saddle of her life. And these movements right here were for many centuries thought to be impossible with a horse, but in fact they're not if you get the confidence of the horse. Now there she is, standing with no restraint. Oh, good girl. 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 Ho ho. Easy now. That's a good girl. You're all right. You're okay. I'm just going to take that line off now, and you'll notice that my pulse rate is not up a tick. I don't care if she wants to buck. That's to be expected. It's all right. I just want to be sure this saddle will ride her. And if it's the first saddle of her life, and it is, she ought to buck with it. Okay. So, I want to be out here now and just be her friend. Be her friend and be here for her. Okay. We belly over at first. And I just want her to carry his weight. He could jump back out of there if she decided that she wanted to take a jump. But it's amazing when you get their confidence that the joined up horse looks up at his first rider, not as an adversary, but as a partner. And certainly with a lot less fear and consternation than the horse who's been started by using the tactics conventional, which are by their very nature adversarial. Easy, easy, good girl. We won't call that bucking yet. Nice and loose on her. Good. Very good. Okay. We've laid a lot of claims out, like, for instance, that this system is non-traumatic. And if it is non-traumatic, I ought to be able to prove it to you. And if I sent you to the library and said, get an armload of books on the subject of animal behavior, you would find in those books several things that the scientists would say that are absolute. One is that this is a flight animal. Horse is a flight animal. Man is a fight animal. You're bringing those two together. Those same scientists would say that the traumatized flight animal must flee the presence of a human being. Anytime a flight animal is traumatized, it has to flee the presence of a human being. They will also say that the most traumatic day in a horse's life is its first saddle, bridle and rider. So in that instance, then, this is a traumatized flight animal and cannot remain in the presence of a human being. Well,